day we had the last event of the 8 events of the 10th annual warrior competition. It's the King's Challenge. Actually, normally every year it's the final and the hardest event in this competition. It's a tier 4 level. Normally we picked the top 15 teams based on the first 4 days results to participate in this event. Their mission in this event is to conduct different stage movement, conduct different engagements using different weapon systems on different target systems. Each team will have at most 3 hours to conduct this event. That's why this event took 3 hours for each team to conduct. Actually, that was the time, the maximum time that was assigned for each team, because it has 9 different stages. It starts from here where we are standing now. The teams after that moved to the first step where they engage different targets using sniper systems. Team on the overall of the event, there were 5 individuals. Then they move to the next stage, which is the grenade range, where they have to engage 5 different target systems using their individual weapons. Then they moved to the dam where they have to bypass a double line obstacle with their gear. Then they moved to the 300 meter range where they have to engage 30 targets for the whole team. Some of them are static targets, some of them are moving targets, some of them are pop-up targets. Following that, they moved to the next stage where they climb a tower, then climb up, then climb it down. Then they move to the next stage where they have to shoot different target systems using different techniques than the previous stage. Then they moved to the next stage, which is stage 8, where they have to climb a tower. Then from the top of the tower, they have to use the 4-5 pistol. We call it the King pistol. Using this pistol, they have to engage 5 different targets for each individual. Then they moved to the urban area there they get a situation where they had high value target which they have to evacuate through the whole urban area. During their movement, they have to engage different pop-up targets who raise on their left side until a specific location where they have to put the HVT, then move to the final point, which is the start point. This event is different. Normally, for the whole events, they get a brief at night for the coming events. For this event, they did not have this brief. They will have to go to a specific location where they get the brief and they get 1 hour to plan and to come up with a plan how to execute the event. Then when they start movement, they get the whole gear, they get their weapons, and they have to run a long distance with various features. You know, this is not easy, but as SF teams, CT teams, they should be used to that. The most important thing for the team leader is to come up with a good plan, because he got 8 individuals in the team, so and he is allowed to use just 5 of them. So after reviewing the whole instructions for this event, he should come up with a smart plan to conduct. This is a big stress on his shoulders. And during the event, he can't guide his teams. They are doing the event by their own. He can watch only. So this is tough for the team leader. This year, the Warrior Competition for us as KASOTC is different. You know, we get more teams this year from different countries. Actually, what we found is what we expected, because after different discussions with the teams, with the observers, the events were tough and challenging for the teams. We get some advanced teams from different countries, so they were competing hard against each other, and we can observe that during the last four days and today, because every day we get the scores are changing based, you know, on the penalties that the teams are having in each event. My message on that, I'm encouraging the whole teams, the current teams that we are having now, and a new teams to join this competition. Yes, it's a challenging event for them, but based on our discussions with them and our notes about the whole events, it's a big lessons learned event. So I'm encouraging everybody to join this event because there is a big chance to get a good lessons out of it. It's open for the whole units from everywhere to join this event. KASOTC offer everything. The teams has to pay for their tickets. There is no fee for the registration. During the competition itself, KASOTC provide everything, the accommodation, the gear, even the weapons. If the teams don't like to get their weapons here, KASOTC can offer that. So in general, during the whole events, the teams just pay for their food. Even if you look at this year's competition, KASOTC conducted or will conduct 2 tours for the teams, and KASOTC will pay everything. That will not cost the teams anything.